Hello, my Pisces risers. This is your cosmic pastor, Jeremy Ryden, using astrology to help you heal deeply and live a full life. And this is the Pisces Rising Secret Series, where I share information and insight for that inspirational rising sign, Pisces. So if you're a Neptune riser, subscribe to my channel, ring the notification bell so you don't miss any future Pisces points that I'll be sharing for this ascendant. Now, today we're talking about the life purpose of being born a Pisces. As I said in previous videos, the most important starting point of your chart is your rising sign, because the rising sign shows us the life path that you're on, the journey that you're taking. Now, this doesn't mean that everybody that's a Pisces riser is identical, because all the planets make up your own experience, and you have free will to make decisions that create your destiny. But there is fate, and the fate is your rising sign. It's these opportunities, these events, these situations that every Pisces riser will experience or innately feel by just being born a Pisces ascendant. So today's secret number two, the life purpose of being a Pisces riser, is coming from the Vedic teachings, the Hindu teachings of the four aims of life. The four aims of life says there's four areas everyone must master on this earth journey. You master these four areas and you master your life. I use astrology to help you master your life, to live your best life. And to do that, we got to start with the first aim of life, and that is your dharma. Dharma is another word for your duty, your responsibility, the right actions that you should be taking in this lifetime. As a Pisces riser, there are actions that you need to take while you're alive that will energize you, inspire you, and help guide you on this life journey. These are the right actions. This is why you were born. This is your higher calling as far as the things you need to be doing on this earth plane. That's why the rising sign is so powerful, for seeing your destiny, for seeing why you're here. So traditionally, when we look for the dharma, why I'm here, what I'm supposed to be doing with my life, we look at the fire signs. What are the fire signs? Aries, Leo, Sagittarius. Why the fire signs? Because fire signs is about inspiration. And so when we're talking about right action, you got to feel inspired to take action. If you don't care about something, if something doesn't give you passion and light you up inside or spark your interest, you're really not going to commit to doing the activities, the effort, and the energy of taking a particular action. That's why fire signs are all about action. And, you know, inspiration means in spirit. So when you're inspired, you're literally in spirit, Pisces. If you're trying to figure out, what is the will of God for my life? What does the universe want for me? Sit down and ask yourself, what lights you up on the inside? What excites you? What makes you come alive and feel like there's a lot of vitality? What inspires you? That inspire is in spirit, which is the universe saying, hey, this is why I created you, to go after these things and to explore these areas of the universe and on earth. So look and see what planets you have in fire signs, because these planets, Pisces, are going to tell you the actions you should be doing, the, you know, where you should be putting your energy, the things that you should be accomplishing, you know, even, you know, as on the material plane. Now, for all Pisces risers, when we look at the whole house astrology, and that's what I'm using for this series. So even if you use a different type of house system, it's still okay to look at the whole house to get an idea where you're at the beginning, the foundational level that makes up every Pisces ascendant. With Pisces risers, we see that you got the fire signs in the second, sixth, and tenth house. Aries rules your second house. And then we have Leo ruling the sixth, and then Sagittarius ruling the 10th. What does this mean about the duty? What does this mean about the Dharma? What does this mean about the responsibility of being born Pisces? Well, the second, sixth, and tenth house are what we call the career houses, the money houses, the your profession, your reputation. And so we know that everyone that is born for a Pisces risers, they have been given talents to really go after their career in this lifetime, to go after making money with their values and their passion and their talent. You know, Aries in the second, right? Second house is what you're speaking about. It's also about how you go after money, what you value. Aries is all about independence. Aries is all about vision and variety. So Pisces risers, in this lifetime, you gotta allow yourself to be independent about going after the things you value. What you value will probably be a lot different than your brother, your sister, your mother, and your father. You must value yourself enough to go after your vision, because Aries is new vision, fresh vision, and exploring. So you will a lot of times go down career paths that are not traditional. You'll care about things that a lot of other people are maybe are not interested in. But you can be a groundbreaker. You can be a trendsetter. You can be open up new doors of making money. Because second house rules about how you go after money. And so part of your duty in this life is to go after money in your own independent way, using your own vision, and also being really, valuing yourself enough to allow yourself to speak your truth. Because the second house of the Vedic system is also about the voice. So we can see that in this lifetime, you are here to speak your vision, speak your truth, share your dreams, share your inspiration. If you see that for some reason you're losing energy, you're losing motivation, it's because you're not sharing your own unique perspective. You're not sharing what is important to you. And so it's very important that you go ahead and say things that maybe no one has ever heard about. Maybe sing it, write it, share it, but your communication must be uniquely yours. It must be something that resonates on the inside, that you feel passionate about and excited about, because Aries, right, is the crusader. So you can make money having a cause that you feel passionate about, whether it's saving the whales, saving children, doing something to change society. You can independently, by speaking your truth, create wealth with, you know, picking up a cause that you feel is important to you. So there's a lot of people that might start nonprofits that are in Pisces. I would think being a Pisces ascendant would make you a great nonprofit starter, or doing something to what I call making impact income. Meaning you're making an impact with your life, and by making that impact, you're making an income. Maybe people that make bracelets, right? But the bracelets, you know, a portion of that money goes to, a charity, or goes to helping the environment. There are millions of different ways, but we know Dharma-wise that your responsibility is to crave out your own path when it comes to the things you value and sharing these new values in the world. You're able to actually pioneer different things that have never been done before when it comes to the work area. You know, when we look at that Leo in the sixth house. Now, sixth house is the house of career, what we're doing day to day, like job, your routine, your day to day stuff. It's important for you to shine in your day to day work. Part of the reason you came here is to be the superstar. And so I'm not asking you to be a drama queen and be, you know, high maintenance, but you need to find a career that allows you to shine, allows you to just really perform almost, because Leo's a performer, but Leo's also a leader. So this idea that Pisces risers are just, pushovers, No, they're compassionate and they got a big heart. But in the workspace, you better believe that a Pisces risers can lead. You look at some of those people that are in the movies and that are in music and theater and art. These are passionate people that will say, no, this is how I'm going to do it. You may have an artist, right, who will follow what the label says because they just want to get their break and make their money. Then you see other artists that after they got their break, they create their own label. They're like, no, I got to have all of the creative freedom to do what is true to me, to my vision, my dream, my voice, my leadership. So Pisces rising, even in the career front, you need to take on those leadership roles. You need to take on, because Leo is responsible leader in, besides just being a performer, it is a leader. So I want to kind of let you know that I don't want you just to sit and be satisfied in your everyday work just being a foot soldier. And not that there's anything wrong with just foot soldiers, but you wouldn't be living up to your dharma. You wouldn't be living up to your duty, the actions you should be taking as climbing the ladder where you work to get into a position where you are the boss, where you are the supervisor, where you are the manager, and, you know, people are following your lead. So, you know, there may be several different types of Pisces when it comes to their everyday work. They may be a performer, an actress, a model, you know, some other type of really what we would call more artistic field, or they may even fall into the, we call that a leadership that I've been talking about the last few minutes of leading and guiding and calling the shots. So there's all kinds of, you know, variables that can take place, Pisces riser, but it is your duty to excel in your everyday job, in your routine, and, you know, and make your everyday life glamorous. It's okay to, you know, say when I walk out the door, you're getting glam, baby. You're getting beauty. You're getting me, magic. And so that's really, really awesome. Now, then we go into that 10th house of Sagittarius. Now, the 10th house is our calling, our higher calling, our vocation. It may not necessarily be the everyday work that we're doing in the sixth, but that 10th house says, what is the legacy that you're leaving in this world? What is the things that you want to contribute to society and people will recognize you for as you grow older? Well, that's Sagittarius, right? That's the truth speaker. Sagittarius is the teacher. It's the guide, right? Because Sagittarius rules the ninth house, right? Ninth house of religion, spirituality, publishing. So part of your duty in this world is to get a reputation of somebody that's got information to share with the world. Whether that's spiritual information, religious information, philosophies, sharing your higher philosophy that it can impact the rest of us, that we can glean from the wisdom that you gain through all of the different experiences that you have. Life coaches, whatever, coaches, counselors, you name it. But you are here to shine in your career, in your work, shine in the things that you do when it comes to how you make money, how you're able to survive. And so I know there's a lot of stuff where people are saying, you know, there's a starving artist, right? That thing where, you know, you're a starving artist and this and that. And I'm not wanting the Pisces to be the starving artist, because you can be a successful artist. But it's going to require, when it comes to your work, that you take the initiative. Fire sign is initiative. It's boldness. It's courage. And so you can't be just sitting around and expecting someone else to open the door for you when it comes to your career, when it comes to your calling, your vocation, when it comes to your reputation. You got to be persistent and put yourself out there. It's kind of like that lady, that young girl that's a waitress in LA. She was raised in Kansas. She moved to LA with a desire to be in the movies. And you know what? years and years, nothing, but sooner or later, somebody sees her and she gets her role. And there's a lot of people like that, that are famous today, that, you know, worked a lot of different odd jobs, but they put themselves in the environment to be seen. They put themselves in the area to be noticed. And what am I saying, Pisces, that you have to be famous or that you have to do something artistic or talented? Not necessarily, but you do need to be aggressive about making your impact in the area of finances, money, making your money, your calling, your career. You know, a lot of you are going to need that 10th house Sagittarius is higher truth, ultimate truth. Ultimately, you need to honor your truth in your career profession. If you're doing something that does not feel in line with your soul, you're not going to be happy. If you're working for a company that is not in alignment with your values, you're not going to be happy, because your truth must line up in the environment you're working in the, whether you're selling something. If you don't believe in that product, you get out of it, because it's so important for your integrity that you're only doing things that you believe in. Sagittarius 10th house is I believe, I know. So if you don't really believe in the place you're working in, have the faith to get out of it and go do something you truly believe. Now, I'm giving all of this stuff. We're talking about Dharma, life purpose. So we want to see what planets you got in 2, 6, and 10. The planets you got in 2, 6, and 10 are really going to tell you where you should be putting your energy and looking to that planet for direction on how you should live your life. So, for example, if you got that moon in the second house, we said that the second house is speaking sometimes, but the moon is our emotion, it's our intuition. So we would say that this particular Pisces must use their intuition when speaking, must use their intuition when deciding on what investments they want to go after, what things they truly value. Do I want to do this or do I want to do that? Let me get quiet and truly listen to my intuition, and that intuition, because of the moon, your feelings, what feels right, will guide you on what you should be doing. Same example that if we had the sun in your 10th house of Sagittarius, now we know what's the sun. Sun is like that Leo sign. It's about leadership, standing out. You know, it's about your identity. So in the 10th house, we would really, really amplify maybe a spiritual teacher, a guru, maybe someone that is really, you know, in the government, high up in hierarchy. Sun a lot of times in 10th means, you know, high government official positions or working your way up in big organizations, because the sun is big. And so all of these, so if you had sun in the 10th, you wouldn't want to be in a small, if you were going to work in an organization, you wouldn't want to be in an organization where you could never have a leadership role, or you could never advance, because sun is big, sun is leadership, sun is authority. So you would have to have a job or career that ultimately would give your reputation authority, being seen as authority figure. All of these things, you know, play a big part. We got Mars in the 6th. Now we're saying that you got to have something where there's a lot of action, you know, because Mars is about action and moving forward and going and doing things. So if you were doing an everyday job that didn't really push you, that didn't really challenge you, that maybe didn't even allow you to move around physically, then you wouldn't be doing your Dharma. So it's the fire signs, right? Aries, Leo, and Sagittarius, we want to look where are the planets in these signs. And for whole house astrology, 2, 6, and 10 are your fire signs. With these planets that are in these houses, what do these planets represent? When you're starting losing your way and you start feeling aimless and you start feeling not energetic, go to your natal chart, look at the planets 2, 6, and 10, Google what they represent, what themes do they govern, what activities do they govern. Begin to do those activities, and you'll start feeling like you're back on your path, that you're back to discovering your purpose. You'll start feeling energized because you're doing what the planet brought you here to do. Now, that's all in the natal chart. If we were wanting more information, traditionally, when we look at the four aims of life, talking about today, aim number one, Dharma, your life purpose, the traditional houses are 1, 5, and 9. So you can also look at the planets that you got in 1, 5, and 9 to get an idea about what you're here to do. Now, for all Pisces ascendants, we got Pisces in the first house, you got Cancer in the fifth, and then Scorpio in the ninth. What does this tell us about your Dharma? What does this tell us about why you're here? Notice, Pisces, Cancer, and Scorpio, these are water planets. These are emotional planets. These are feeling. When I'm saying planets, I'm talking about zodiac. I mean zodiac. These are zodiac signs that are feeling, intuitive, deep, because when we look at water, we're going down into the depth. And so this tells us, Pisces rising, that you are here to explore your emotions. You are here to feel fully. You know, my tagline for many years, hi, I'm Cosmic Pastor Jeremy Ryden, using astrology to what? Help you heal deeply and live fully. You cannot live fully, Pisces, if you are not feeling your feelings fully, if you're not exploring your emotions. How does this song move me? How does this writing move me? How does the sunset move me? You are here to be emotional. Don't let anyone say, oh, you're too emotional. Oh, you're not, you know, you're not logical. Pisces, if you try to only be logical and not open up your heart and live life by your heart, you're not doing your Dharma. You're not living life according to why you're here on this earth. It is our emotions that make us our human. You always watch those vampire shows and the vampire says, I turn off my humanity and that's why I could kill everybody because I feel nothing. Well, Pisces, you're not here to turn off your emotions. Turning off your emotions will make you not, it'll make you lose your humanity, but it will also make you lose your energy. It'll make you lose your direction because your emotions is your compass on whether you're going in the right direction or the wrong direction. Now, this doesn't mean we always have to be happy. Sometimes your sad emotions, sometimes your angry emotion, every emotion is sending a message to you. You just got to learn how to decipher the messages without shutting down or being overwhelmed or jumping to conclusions. But emotions are very powerful for guiding you in the direction that you should be going in your life. We got Pisces in the first. What does this tell us? This tells us that right off the bat, your spirituality is going to play a big role in you living out your calling on this earth. Sagittarius in 10th, right? Remember I said that? Sagittarius in 10th, that's your reputation. First house is your identity. It's got Pisces. Sagittarius and Pisces are ruled by Jupiter. Jupiter is a planet of expansion, knowledge, spiritual growth, soul growth. And so this tells us in this lifetime, you're here to grow spiritually. You're here to grow your soul. You're here to learn as much information as you can. Learn a little from this culture, a little from that culture. You're not putting yourself in a box. You're allowing yourself to be open to all the possibilities. Because Pisces is ruled by Neptune. That first house ruled by Neptune is about universality. It's about not trying to box yourself in, but open up the box and see maybe this, maybe that. You know, that's why when I said in the first video, Neptune being your most important planet, there can be confusion because there's so many opportunities to explore your imagination, to explore different cultures, to explore different things in this world. And that's okay. You're here to explore all the different things that when it comes to tradition and truth and all these teachings and what we've been taught from the scholars and different gurus, that Pisces in the first house identity says part of you is to be open to all these different teachings to see how they feel to you, to see how it resonates to you. If you're a Pisces riser and you want to know, is this the ultimate truth? Is this really true for me? It isn't so much about the logic of it or the proof of it. But the question is, how does this make me feel? Do I resonate? Does it feel true to me? Because Neptune's a feeling planet. Sagittarius in the 10th is about truth. Your truth will be based on whether it feels right. If something doesn't feel right to you, Pisces, you must not accept it. Even if it's right for everyone else on the planet, that's their right to believe their truth. But for me, when I'm interpreting truth, I must see, how does this make my life feel? Does it empower me? Does it encourage me? Does it inspire me? If that truth doesn't, then I'm going to put it on the side and I'm going to wait for what truth comes that does resonate. So that's that Pisces in the first. Then we're looking at the fifth house. That fifth house has a Cancer in it. And I know I'm already 25 minutes in. I hope you love this, Pisces. I hope you guys will smash the thumb like and really get into astrology. This is, my channel isn't, you know, sugarcoat. My channel is for those that want to get deep. And so we're talking about 1, 5, and 9 because that's the traditional Dharma houses. Those are the traditional houses for actions. So whatever planets you got there, you want to take action with that planet traditionally. Now, natally, remember yours is 2, 6, and 10. Look at 2, 6, and 10 first. And then after that, go to 1, 5, and 9. 5 has Cancer in it. So this lets us know that you're very romantic in romance because Cancer is emotion, it's intuition, it's ruled by the moon. So this means you can fluctuate a lot in your romantic life, in your dating life, because moon is up and down. So that's why Pisces seem temperamental. A lot of people are like, oh, I don't want to date a Pisces, because you are ruled a lot by emotions and emotions fluctuate. And so you realize that, but it also means that you're very intuitive when it comes to your art, music, creativity, dance. You know, Cancer is all about emotions. Fifth house is all about our creativity and our children. So Pisces are very dedicated to their children, very loving to their children, those Pisces riser with that Cancer in the fifth house. So they make great caretakers, mothers, fathers, teachers, preschool, you name it. A Pisces is a very healing and gentle presence on children. And Pisces music, or like I said, I keep saying creativity, but creativity can be anything. Think out of the box. Anything that you're creating and you're producing can have a very healing effect, a very soothing effect, a very, you know, trigger an emotional response, because you've got Moon, the planet of emotion, in the fifth house that is all about emotions in a lot of ways, with our heart and our romance and our feelings. So, you know, just make sure that when you are dating, that you realize that your emotions will fluctuate a lot and that you don't make a lot of, you know, hasty decisions based on what you're feeling today. That'll go a long ways in helping you in your romantic life. Now, we also know that you're very nurturing to other people with the things that you're producing, because Moon is nurture in the fifth house of what we're creating. Your work, what you're producing, should have an encouraging and nurturing and uplifting element to it. Then we go into that ninth house of Scorpio. So Pisces risers are very deep. People think, oh, Pisces is, you know, scatterbrain. That's not true, my friend. Our brains are just constantly searching on the deep things. Because Scorpio's deep. It's about research, digging down deep. That's why Pisces are into mystical and magic. It's not just because they're like, oh, I believe in the fairies. It's because they study esoteric knowledge, astrology, meditation. They've opened themselves up to allow their mind to really explore what's going on in the inside of themselves. Because that ninth house, right, is all about higher truths. It's about connecting to the divine. And so the deeper Pisces goes down into their thoughts and their feelings and their truth, the higher they rise up in their connection to God, Goddess, anything that you want to really talk about as far as, you know, that higher power. Pisces has a real deep connection to their faith, a real deep connection to their inner truth, a real deep connection to their philosophies. So these are not wishy-washy people. These are people of conviction. Yes, sometimes they may fluctuate while they're trying to see what they really feel about what they're learning, but ultimately it's because they passionately care about the higher meaning of life and the higher reason of why we're here and what it's all about. So there you have it, the life dharma, the first aim of the four aims of life. Are you following your feelings? Are you being honest with your what you're speaking and saying? Are you being sensitive to the things that you're trying to create and put out in the world? So Pisces, look at those planets in 2, 6, and 10. Look at the fire signs and look at what other planets you have in 1, 5, and 9. If you like this, hit the, give me the thumbs up, hit the smash, the like, write in the comments. Share your thoughts and feelings in the comments, and we'll see you here in secret number 3 when we talk about more of the aims of the four aims of life for Pisces.